What's up, everybody? John the Morgyle here, gonna do a quick flat earth video for you. Hope you enjoy it. This one is really great evidence against the ball earth theory. Starting out, we've got a diagram of the solar system that I pulled from an online source that even globe earthers will say is adequate. Sure, it's not 3D, it's nothing fancy, nothing special, but it is adequate to describe the inner solar system. And the big issue, real quick, is this past Saturday, the 16th of June, 2018, Venus was visible in the night sky well after 11 o'clock p.m. Eastern. And if you take a look at this image here, my friend Jason in Michigan shot this after 11. Now, if you look at online sources, they'll say that Venus actually set at 11, but clearly this thing had another good at least half hour, 45 minutes before it would have set behind the horizon here. And so the big problem with this is, of course, the fact that in the heliocentric theory, Venus and Mercury as well are, we're talking about Venus here, is supposedly on a tighter orbit around the Sun compared to the Earth. And so how would it be possible for someone on the night side of Earth to get a line of sight towards Venus, right? Okay, so just took this same diagram to scale and expanded it a bit. But how would it be possible on this ball Earth here to, after 11 o'clock p.m., which would position you, you know, somewhere around right here on the ball, your line of sight is going to be tangent to this curve. So obviously the side of the Earth that's away from the Sun is going to be the night side at any point on this hypothetical orbital trajectory. And if an observer is positioned on this clear on the night side of the sphere, obviously by after 11 o'clock p.m., their line of sight would be tangent to this curve. And so if we'll just assume in a perfect world that this point here would be right about here would be midnight, so somewhere around in here would be about 11. And of course, that line of sight is going to be tangent to the curve. And so it is quite impossible to have a clear line of sight towards the inner solar system, Venus in this particular case, after 11 o'clock p.m. Just simply does not work in the ball Earth model. Because, as you can clearly see, this line of sight is never going to converge with Venus's alleged orbital path. And so, in case you think I'm making this up, you can just do a quick Google search for what time did Venus set on 6/16/18. And so this was according to an observer in Illinois. It says Venus set at 11:05 p.m. although it seems like if you were in Michigan that date, maybe a little higher elevation, who knows, you could actually get a line of sight towards Venus later than that, as documented in this image, which was taken after 11 on Saturday the 16th. So, again, the simple fact of observing Venus after, well after sunset, well into the time when it should have been well below the horizon for any observer on the night side of the hypothetical ball Earth. Now, of course, this doesn't prove that the Earth is flat, although it does debunk the heliocentric theory, which in my mind is just as good because, of course, everyone is led to believe that the heliocentric theory, the ball earth theory, is infallible and is true and correct. Yet, this one single observation of Venus after 11 p.m. debunks the heliocentric theory. There is no logical argument against this. The simple fact is that we should not be able to get a line of sight towards Venus after really an hour or two after sunset, but certainly not approaching the hour of midnight, as it clearly was this past weekend. And really, the same sort of thing can be done or can be said about the moon's phases. Oftentimes, we'll see a full moon in broad daylight. And of course, the full moon would necessarily be on the opposite side of the Earth relative to the sun. This is where the full moon would necessarily be. And even nearly full moon would have the moon positioned here or here, and in many cases, I've personally witnessed the moon overhead many hours after sunrise, so like into the afternoon. I've witnessed the moon, the full moon, clear on the opposite side of the Earth than where it should be. The same opposite thing goes for crescent moons. But this one here, with Venus being visible well into the midnight hours, clear off onto nearly midnight after 11 p.m., is a big, huge nail in the coffin for the globe. And of course, you'll get trolls who say that, oh, well, you don't understand geometry and you don't understand how big space is. Of course, the further you place these hypothetical objects in space, the worse this problem gets. Because, again, if your line of sight towards visible space after sunset is tangent to the Earth's curve, then even just a couple hours after sunset, you should not expect to get a clear line of sight towards Venus, regardless of how far you hypothetically place that object. And again, there is even yet another problem with this. When Venus is at its closest, again, humoring the heliocentric theory, it would be not lit. The sun would be reflecting light off of the backside of Venus, according to us, out into space. So we certainly could never see Venus when it is closest to the Earth, hypothetically. On the other hand, when Venus is would be at its furthest away, it would be clear on the opposite side of the Earth, clear on the opposite side of the Sun relative to the Earth, and so we certainly would not expect to see Venus during broad daylight when it would hypothetically be fully lit. So quite frankly, the only times we would expect to even have a chance to a line of sight towards Venus would be in the rare occasions when it is off to the sides of the sun relative to the Earth. And of course, that would be indirectly half-lit Venus, but that would be the only time that a line of sight towards Venus would even be remotely possible after sunset, of course. Yet, when you look at the months of the year that Venus was actually visible in the night sky after sunset, it's practically every month. There are rare occasions, rare months of the year where you can't get a line of sight towards Venus. However, the rule here should be no line of sight towards Venus after sunset, except on perhaps very rare occasions, but certainly not visible practically every month of the year. And this one here, you know, I didn't even think it was possible to get a line of sight towards Venus, quite frankly, after 10 or 11 o'clock p.m. There just is no explanation for it in the globe Earth, you know, ball Earth heliocentric theory. And so yet again, the ball Earth falls flat on its face to explain observable reality. Now, this doesn't mean we have to explain what Venus is and what it's doing. Venus is yet another heavenly light that is a mystery to us. And to try to put rational explanations on these things, I think, is an exercise in futility. But we're also sort of kidding ourselves if we think that we can ascribe, you know, physical properties and explain exactly what these wandering stars are. So just wanted to get that out there. Big thanks to Jason in Michigan. He's doing some really good work there. Saturday night, I could not get a visual on the sky. It was a little bit overcast for me. So luckily, he was able to capture that. And with that, I'm going to wrap this video up. Thanks so much for watching. If you'd care to support this channel, your support is greatly needed and appreciated. You can do a one-time contribution to PayPal at www.paypal.me/themorgyle or a recurring monthly contribution through Patreon for as little as $1 per month at www.patreon.com/themorgyle. So God bless you all. Thanks again for watching. Spread the word, spread the world, and peace. The earth shakes. Make the earth shake.